Explorations are done in a flexible workspace where you can discover and analyze data, uncover hidden relationships, and identify patterns that turn your data into insights. In this video, you will see how to use a data asset as an exploration data source, how to start an exploration with a data relationship diagram, how the assistant suggests visualizations based on your data, how to pick your own visualization and data, and how to compare data. I extracted the sales receipts file from the coffee sales zip file, which is on the IBM Accelerator catalog. This will be the file that I use during this demonstration. To start the exploration, since I'm pointing at the file right now, I can just click More, Create Exploration. I need a starting point for the exploration, and several measures are suggested. I'm going to use the line item amount. The first thing gets created is the data relationship chart, and this shows me the relationship between the line item amount and other values that are in the file. One thing I can do is edit the diagram and see secondary relationships. The thickness of the lines suggests the strength of the relationship. So for example, the strength from the promo item to product ID and from product ID to line item amount is suggesting that promo ID drives some of the sales that are made. So currently line item amount is selected. And to the right are visualizations that Cognos Analytics is suggesting might be of interest to me. I can see, for example, that there was $417,000 in line item amounts. I'm going to select the line item amount and order by transaction time graph and see what insights I get from that. When I select it, it moves to the center. So one of the things I notice is that with the column, order is sum. Now I happen to know that the order is in fact the order number attached to the order, so it doesn't make sense to create it as a total. I can make that adjustment by selecting the source and then selecting properties for order. I'm going to change that to count because then I'll get a count of the number of orders. And I think rather than a measure, it really should be identifier. So I can see right away that my graph has redrawn with this new aggregation information. So I can see now at 11:18 that there were 9 orders, and I can see that they had a total value of $385.65. So that might be something of interest for me as I'm doing my analysis. I might want to try to dive in deeper, and if I had a slightly richer data set that described the products, for example, I might start a line of analysis where I try to identify, well, what's causing those high value transactions at that particular time. So my hypothesis right now might be, well, those are maybe catering orders that are coming in for lunch. Running along the top, I can also click on visualization, and I'm presented with different visualizations using that same data that I've got selected. I could also click related, and Cognos Analytics will show me data that is related to the data I've selected, which might give me some insights. And I'm going to talk about compare later. But first, what I want to do is do some analysis around, are there any particular employees that are contributing to sales quite well? So in that case, what I can do is I can click Create. I'm going to create a single visualization, and I choose the type of visualization I want. So in this case, I'm going to use the column chart. And I'm going to drop staff ID onto the bars. I'm going to drop line item amount onto the length. And I'm going to sort it descending so I can see highest selling employee to the lowest. But I'm going to dig a little deeper now, and I'm going to wonder what happens if I include sales outlet. And I can see right away that employee 20 is not in the lead anymore. But now employee 42, in fact, leads at store 8. Trying to understand what's happened there, one thing I can do is use the compare. And what I'll use is the duplicate. And I can click on the left on the card. I can now see my column chart has been duplicated. So now if I wanted to compare employees, what I can do is I can come up to the staff ID and apply a filter. On the left-hand side, I'm going to use employee 42. And in chart B, I'm going to filter for employee 20. So right away, I can get some insight that employee 42, $19,000 in sales. And I can see employee 20 has a total of 29,000. So I can see that employee 20, in fact, is still leading. I have this comparison slider, so I can say, well, there's the top of employee 20 in store 5. I can see over on the left-hand side how they're performing. So that wraps up using exploration with a uploaded data file. You've seen how you can augment your analysis by uncovering relationships in the data, providing insights and correlations, and enabling comparisons for further understandings. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in Team Content.